Globe Theater has been dark for the past 7 months due to the pandemic. However, they have found ways to continue to make theater under the state's restrictions. And joining us now to talk a little bit more about it is the Old Globe's artistic director, Barry Edelstein. Barry, good to talk to you tonight.
Thanks for having me.
All right, so I know you had to get creative, and I believe you took the Old Globe to a virtual platform. How's that going?
Well, it's pretty amazing, I have to say. We've basically pivoted all of our programming, our artistic programming, our educational programming, and our community-based arts engagement programming onto digital platforms, Facebook Live, YouTube, Instagram. And it's very successful. A lot of people are watching, a lot of people are responding, and we're finding ways to keep our audience engaged while we're closed in Balboa Park.
I mean, this is really difficult when you think your whole, the premise of the Old Globe and everything you do there is to perform, to interact with people. And yet right now we got to keep at a distance and you got to keep the face masks on. How is that affecting the crews?
Well, the superpower of the theater is to bring a group of strangers together into one place and turn them into an audience, into sort of one collective group. And with the virus raging, it's just not safe to do it. And we can't do that. So we have to find a way to create community and bring people together in some kind of alternative way. And what we do is, you know, sometimes we'll do these virtual things live. So we'll say to everybody, 6:30 p.m., you got to be on YouTube. And it has the same kind of feeling of making theater, even though we're all not physically together in the same room.
All right, well, let's talk about the upcoming season. November and December, huge for the Old Globe. For one reason, two words, the Grinch. What's going to happen?
Yeah, well, it's the 23rd year of Dr. Seuss's How the Grinch Stole Christmas, which is, of course, a holiday tradition at the Old Globe and in San Diego. And we are in the final stages of figuring out what our pivot is going to be now that the authorities won't let us perform, and not quite ready to break the news to you right now, I'm sorry to say, but stay tuned, and the Globe's going to be able to make an announcement in about a week's time. It's actually pretty exciting what we're planning, and I think people are going to be really turned on by it. I'm sorry that I can't tell you right now.
Well, this is such a huge part of San Diegans' life as far as, you know you can rely on it. Right after Thanksgiving, you know where you can go to watch The Grinch and see it in a way that you can't see it anywhere else. So you've got a lot of people asking you questions about this, I assume.
We do. People want to know what we're going to be able to do. But, you know, our audience has been amazingly understanding. People read the papers. People understand that live theater is simply closed down up and down the state of California, all across the United States. It's just not safe yet for everybody to gather and sit next to each other cheek by jowl. I'm so grateful that our audiences have been understanding, that our philanthropists have continued to support us. The Globe is here. The lights are on. We're doing all kinds of work. And the Grinch is going to be with us. I promise you that. I just am not, can't tell you quite exactly how for another few days.
Oh boy, I can hardly wait to hear that one. I know you can't give us the details, but let me ask you this. If the state changes their guidelines and allows you to go into full production, would you be able to make that pivot considering whatever plan you have in the works that you'll reveal to us next week?
So every plan that we've got has got a ramp up time. We can't just go from zero to having 600 people sitting in the auditorium overnight. So everything involves some advance time. I mean, artists coming in from out of town, scenery that has to be built, tickets that have to be sold. So there's always some prep time going on. I can tell you that we are in discussion with the governor's office to try and figure out a way to get the regulations opened up a little bit, because there are other lines of work that restaurants and movie theaters that are allowed to operate under certain capacity restrictions. So the Globe is working with theater companies and other live event producers all up and down the state of California to try and advocate with public health authorities to get us back into business sooner. And the reason for that is that we have people that work at the Globe. It's a business. It's a small business that employs well over 200 people on a full and part-time basis and close to 800 people as contractors. And these people are out of work, and that's no good. And we've got to get the Globe running again so that we can get our folks back to work.
Well, it's a well-loved business as well, Barry. So I applaud you for all the efforts you're going to, the lengths you're going to not just bring theater to San Diegans, but also to help culture the community that you have there. Look forward to hearing from you next week as well, okay?
We'll have some news for you, Ginger. Thanks a million.
Thank you. Be well.
Bye.